Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in North Carolina. Hope you guys are doing all right. I moved the computer over here because my son's taking a bath and it's pretty loud. Hope you guys are doing all right. Haven't made many videos, been on the road from May 15th until yesterday. Been on the road, traveling all the way, and then here I went to a wedding in Philadelphia. After driving from Dallas to North Carolina, then to Philadelphia and back. So by the grace of God, we made it safe. The Lord gave us his protection, travel, and mercies. I thank you, all you guys who prayed. I just want to make an announcement, for the orphanage. We're in the middle of construction. But you've been watching my videos. Those who normally watch my videos, we're in construction to add on some bathrooms and two more bedrooms. There at the one bedroom at each of the orphanages. And then what we call a dirty kitchen or an outside kitchen with a oven and all that separate from the house and an eating area. It's kind of like, it's got screen, like half cement, and then the top half, this thick screen. It'll be durable and not be so hot. And plus, removes a fire hazard from the house and all that. That's how they used to build houses in the States before, when everybody cooked with wood. They had what they call a dirty kitchen. The kitchen was separate because of the heat and because of the fire danger. So they still do that in the Philippines because most people cook with wood or coal, or actually they make charcoal out of the coconut shells and also out of wood. But anyway, brothers and sisters, I was going to tell you about that, and that the school children, we have about 27 or 28 orphans now. School is starting in the Philippines the second week of June. I ask you guys to pray about that. A lot of the kids need a uniform. Some of the kids have a uniform from last year. Can be handed down to a smaller orphan, maybe. Some of them need shoes. Some of them have shoes, maybe. They really all need some shoes for school. They've grown and all that, and they get wore out, from hand-me-downs too much. I'm not sure, the status of every what we've got available. We've got boxes coming. Thank all you guys who sent stuff to Sister Pearly. And of course, it hasn't gotten here yet, and hopefully it will be here maybe by the second week of June. That's all up in the air. I know there's some shoes and stuff in there now. Will we have enough for some of the orphans and all that? I don't know, how it all work out. Then we're also giving stuff away, to the 500 plus kids we feed every week. Lots of them are in much worse shape than the orphans. The orphans are doing good because they're at the orphanage. So all those kids, I've been making the orphans a priority, but I really want to give more out to the feeding programs. If you saw my slideshow I made, if you go to my channel, look back about two or three videos, I made a slideshow of the orphans. And that was actually, those pictures I used in the slideshow aren't as bad as lots of the pictures that I have and lots of the feeding programs. There's much more poverty than what's shown in those in my slideshow. In the really poor areas, we don't even take pictures because it's in a poor area and the pastor doesn't even really know how to operate the camera and stuff. So I've gone there myself and done it every once in a while over the years that I've been doing the feeding program. Some of the feeding programs I've been doing since 2006 in different areas. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I wanted to come on here and make a video. And like I said, when I make these announcements up front, there's lots of people that run to and fro on the internet trying to hear a word of when the rapture is going to be and all this stuff. And they don't care about nothing else but when they're going to be escaping. A lot of the videos, I never really talk about that, but, directly. But the problem is people are so cold-hearted, so selfish. And when the rapture happens, then when they look that they have no rewards, no fruits, they've done nothing for the Lord, they've borne no fruits in the kingdom of God. That's why, the people that are so popular, the most popular people in the ministry, on not just YouTube, YouTube is one of them. YouTube, the most popular people on YouTube, and then in the world, the biggest names of the ministry stuff, it's all about, it's just, baby milk. As it tells us that, John 3:16, getting born again, evangelism, that's awesome. Number one, people need to be saved. We know that. But as an example, when I started out, I was an assistant pastor in a Baptist church. Everyone in the church but me, and maybe there was, and a few of their kids, most of the people have been going to the same church for 25, 30 years. Okay? Like the longest Christian in the church was like 25 years. 20 years, not counting, you know, their children and stuff maybe. But the vast majority of the church, 90%, everybody in the church was a Christian. And every week, it's, I'm glad I'm saved. I'm glad I'm not, you know, preaching to the choir. I'm glad I'm not like those people out in the world that's going to hell. We're saved. We know we're saved. We're using our King James Bible. We know we're saved. We're going to heaven. Amen. I know I'm saved. Amen. That's it. Nothing about sanctification, holiness, serving the Lord, fruit, rewards in heaven, or, you know, storing up our treasure in heaven and all those things. As it tells us in Hebrews chapter 6, it's time to move on, you know, from the baptism, talking about getting baptized and talking about getting saved and talking about the basic elements. It says that, you know, you just like a baby, a newborn baby's on milk, but a baby has to grow, become a toddler, and needs to learn to read, to walk, to read, to write, to talk, you know, to go to the bathroom, all the things that's needed. And that's what my channel's about. And that's why, brothers and sisters, you know, there's so few people. There's many are called, but few are chosen. Many people just want to be, hey, I want to get in the rapture. Oh, I want to be saved. You know, I'm going to punch my my trip ticket to go to heaven. I know I'm saved. I know I'm going to heaven. That's all I need to have to do with God. I got my ticket punched when I was 8 years old. I went to the altar and said a prayer, living in the world, living for the devil, not even living for the devil. Let's just back that up. Because lots of the people, let's just say they're not living for the devil. I want to back that up because it's much worse than that. The devil's got them so fooled. It's much worse than saying, you know, if I say someone's living for the devil, which I've been saying in the past, and then people say, well, you know, I'm not a devil worshiper. I'm not in witchcraft. I don't watch pornography. I don't get drunk. See, he's not talking to me. So the Lord has just prompted me to say this. You're not living for the devil. You're living for yourself. You know, your theme song is a Frank Sinatra song. You know, I did it my way. So, and Elvis sang that too. I did it my way. So you're the one that's on the throne. So lots of people want Jesus to be their Savior, but not their Lord. So in other words, you got to get off the throne and let Jesus get on the throne of your heart. I've got a second message I want to make, so I'm not going to cross up my messages here. Let me finish this video. You got to get off the throne and let Jesus get on the throne of your heart. Let Jesus be the Lord of your life. And like I said, you're going to be many people. All those thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of people who view videos all day long and looking for rapture dreams, when's the rapture, when are we going to have all this exaggerated news stories, over-exaggerated half-truths news story, alleged biblical, you know, tribulation fulfillments, which they're not, the tribulation period has not begun. All those false prophets on YouTube, and I'm going to say it, more aggressively now because it's becoming painfully obvious that Obama is not the Antichrist. All the false prophets who said the Lord told them that Obama's the Antichrist and built their channel off of that. We're seeing now some of those people have had an evolution and a new revelation that now moving toward the Vatican, the Pope, now some of them, now they've been making videos the last year, but they prophesied some of them outright 2008 that Obama was the Antichrist. All this hating on President Obama. As I said, someone made a video that I was a false prophet because I said Obama is either not the Antichrist or if he has not been revealed. Biblically, the man of sin will be revealed when he makes a seven-year covenant. And that's not the inauguration of the President of the United States, as some videos have been saying and people have been saying. The inauguration of the President of the United States is not making a covenant with many. And that covenant with many will be to allow Israel to rebuild the temple, divide the land of Israel, and make peace between the Muslims and the Jews, and it will be for a seven-year period. Now that man will be the Antichrist. And it might not even be that Jesuit who's actually, you know, he's full-blooded Italian, like Peter the Roman, full-blooded Italian, whose parents were immigrants from Italy, who is now the current Pope. It doesn't mean that he is the man. He's ushering in the way for the man, even though it could be him. Could be him. I'll say that. Or he's opening the door, bringing it all together for the man of sin to come forward. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I said I was going to stay on topic. I have another video to make. God bless you guys. And bear fruit for the Lord. Stop running to and fro looking for the rapture And because the rapture is just a moment, then boom, it's over with. And if you're worthy, as Jesus said, to all you greasy gracers are believe you say a prayer when you're 8 years old, live like the devil, or live for yourself all of your life and go to heaven. Jesus said, let me just give you one of many verses, Luke 21:36. When Jesus got through talking about the tribulation period and the end times and all that, he said, watch therefore and pray always that you be counted worthy to escape these things. What things? The tribulation period. And stand before the Son of Man. It's a command from our Lord Jesus Christ. So therefore, brothers and sisters, the prayers that the Lord gave us to pray is pray always that you be counted worthy to escape, not looking for the date, trying to set a date, because he said no man would know the day or the hour. Okay? And number two, Jesus said, and this is the part that I'm bringing to your attention today, the most important thing you can remember, Jesus did not command us to pray for souls to get saved. What Jesus commanded us to pray is, the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, pray that the Lord of the harvest will send forth laborers into the field. Jesus said, look, in the verse before that, Jesus said, look at the field. You say it's 4 months and then the harvest, but I say, look at the field. It's white and ready to be harvested. The people are ready to be saved. The people are ready to be harvested. The problem is not praying for your hard-headed, wicked relatives to get saved. What the Lord told us to pray for is for laborers to go into the field to reap the harvest of those who are ready, those who are ripe, those who will be saved, as the Lord knows from the foundation of the world, who will be saved and who will not. We do not know that. We need to pray that laborers will go forth into the vineyard, brothers and sisters. If you pray, listen, this is the problem with all this shallow-minded, mile-wide, one-inch-deep foolishness that's on YouTube. If you pray according to your own will, which is, Lord, save my relatives, Lord, please save my relatives, then it's not really effective. But when you pray, brothers and sisters, and bring all of your vain imaginations, as the Bible says, into captivity to the Word of God, and you pray in line with what the Word says, then you will see the effect of God's Word, because His Word is sharp, is like it says in Hebrews 4:12, it's sharp and powerful than a two-edged sword, even dividing asunder the thoughts and intents of the heart, and separating bone and marrow. In other words, the Word of God can split hairs. The Word of God knows the thoughts and intents of your heart and the thoughts and intents of your relatives' hearts who need to be saved. So when you pray in line with the Word of God, brothers and sisters, then the Word of God is of effect. But when you pray your own way and your own will, it is of no effect. That is the biggest problem standing in the way of people's relatives getting saved, because you're not praying in accordance with the Word of God. I'm going to go, brothers and sisters, and I have another video to make.